Todd Vanderlin.
Speak up.
I went to school at Parsons School of Design, where Zach teaches for my undergrad, and I left about my senior year. You should stay in school, though. It's a good idea. I left to about, I think it was like 2003 or, no, 5 or something like that. And I started a research lab at a company, an advertising company called Arnold Worldwide. They have offices all over the country that focus more on traditional advertising. And our goal was to create a research lab there where we're focused strictly on just inventing new interactive toys and ideas for whatever projects may come about. So we weren't directly put on advertising business because I don't know anything about that stuff. So it's kind of a strange context. It's in a big corporate building. This is the building. And there's a bunch of like ad guys. And we have a bar called Barnold, which is pretty awesome. And there's always a keg there. And in this like big corporate cubicle setting, there's like this barn in the skyscraper. And this is what we have. We have tools, we have screens, projectors, cameras, everything just to hack with. There's kind of this idea that we have this big sign outside. This guy with the beard, he's Pete. He's the guy that, it's dark. He owns the company, and he hired me, and the guy in the middle is Ryan, and he and I started it. And this idea of play is what we do. We make things, and whatever they may be, we kind of just put little Lego blocks together to come up with little ideas and show the rest of the advertising company, hey, look what you could do, what could you can make. I have a little video, so it's gonna kind of explain some of these little projects. Demos to kind of just, I thought that would be more fun than going over more and more videos that you can probably just find online. So demos are fun, but they're also difficult because they might break live. So let's try. So one little thing, a little wrapper I built for a physics library, it's called Box2D. So these are just a bunch of little examples of that you can download with the add-on. And just kind of, you can make a whole interaction with those. So I have this, let's see if this works. I don't know how dark it is, this is gonna be tough. All right, hold on here. Whoa, feedback, that's awesome. That's part of the app. All right, let's try, one sec. This is gonna be impossible. All right, well, we'll get the general idea here, but basically this is using OpenCV to create a contour around my silhouette, but this would be in a better situation than what we're in right now. You would get a better silhouette. And Block Studio is creating an outline.
Todd, I could blank that project.
Oh, actually, this is great. No, this is going to work right here.
Okay.
So I'll pretend my hand is much larger. So like this is just a really simple example of just, you know, playing with shapes. You know, you get the idea. So, yeah, if I blank the screen, it'll probably be better, but we got a bunch of these little demos, so. So I mean, it comes with like just playing with particles. These particles could be whatever you want, you know, and they're, you know, you can drag them around and throw them around. This is triangles. Oh, this sucks. There you go. Boop. Now we're dark. And here's like so contacts. You can make like little music machines. I'll invert this one as well. So I can. So here's an app that I built with a friend, Joel Gathan-Lewis. It was for the circus in London. I don't know much about the circus there. So this is going to be super crazy with the feedback here. But let's try. It might even be really cool. So the idea is they wanted to make like a funhouse mirror. So I built all these like little interactions that they could play with, and you'd walk up and you'd see kind of like a full-length mirror, and it was really a screen, and it would distort you in different ways. So let's try to see if this works. We'll get feedback. It'll be fun. So this sucks.
I'll try. Let me blank that back.
I think actually, if you just turn the lights on again, that would really work. Yeah.
Right on the side there.
Right this side. Whoa. All right. Yeah. That works. So the idea here is I can show a lot of like what's going on behind the scenes, which might be a little bit more helpful. So this is our image coming in, and we do some kind of motion differencing on it. So we get, let's see which one it is. So you can see, this is like impossible.
There has to be a middle ground.
I know, there's somewhere we'll figure this out. It looks great on my screen. hold on, what if I like do this? I mean, I'll be inverted, but like, is that? Yeah,
right.
Let's do that. Just imagine that, like invert your eyes or something. Okay. So like, what you can see here is that as I move around, these vectors are kind of shooting off of me. And so what I'm doing is I'm looking at how long those are. And if they're long enough, it looks at that color pixel and shoots it at me. It's like now really bright. So we can try to show this a little bit. It's a little bit like kind of painting live demos. Yeah. So and there's different modes here. So these would all be they were kind of randomized in the installation. So now this one you can kind of draw like, with little motion trails. And then you could add a field, so there's a little bit more feedback, and it looks like it's kind of moving. And you can really, really just play with this and get tons of different effects. So, you know, how much can release, how fast they can go, so it'll shoot off of you a bit faster. It gets kind of nuts with that. Whoa, feedback. But this is kind of fun. Yeah, and then like how big they are. It'd be cooler if you could play with it too. So then there's another mode, which is like this kind of like shattering. So the idea here is, wow, this looks so messed up because I'm like inverted. Oh man, all right. Wait a second, I have to figure this out. Why am I the correct color there?
He's inverting it twice.
Just multiply by -1. That's crazy. All right, so the idea here is you create a certain amount of motion, and there's I'm doing like a psycho element right now, so it's going to be kind of tough, but you make that, and you can kind of shatter. So I like this idea of like shattering your teeth. So you get it just right, you can like. I'm hoping to sell this to some like Colgate or like some dental company. So that's Oh, I got one more thing to show. So those are like a bunch of little demos, and that's an actual use of those demos in an installation. And I have something I really want to release soon for iTunes. Oh, this is going to be funny because it's going to do all that speaking. I'll turn the sound off. It's really hard to debug iTunes. I haven't quite figured it out yet. So the idea is like you could build your OF app, any like really cool visualization, and take the same code and just plug it into this project, and it will work in iTunes for visualizers. So if you look here, you'll see OF iTunes demo. And if I run, I don't know what we're going to play. Hopefully I don't have anything embarrassing. And this is also nerd. This is crazy. So this is basically a lot of the demos that OF comes with running completely in iTunes. So you got like 3D model loading, dir list and images loading, camera, and the spectrum analysis. I should use the mouse over here. Movie player, text, OpenCV. I have no idea why you want any of these things in iTunes. That's where like people can make these and do things. But you get like the album art, you get information about the songs. I think it would be really fun to, and I mean, this is new and I haven't really thought about all of this, but I think if you could somehow like buy an album on iTunes, and instead of getting like a stupid PDF of the cover art, which yes, it's beautiful, but like, you know, it's not very interactive, but if it came with like a visualizer for that album, I think that's the hippest. Yeah. So that's where I hope this kind of goes. I don't know if they'll let you do that in the Apple Store, but you can go full screen, you can do, I think that'd be pretty fun. So look forward to this. It's really, that's what I got.
Thanks,
Todd. Yeah.